Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. Welcome everyone to another course, and this time we are going to cover dependency injection. Dependency injection is one of the most important design patterns that you must understand as a software engineer. Dependency injection is a technique that is widely used in software engineering to eliminate coupling of code. And that is why the concept is also used while building Android apps. In this course, first we will understand what exactly is dependency injection, and after that we will learn applying the concept of dependency injection or DI in our Android projects. We will cover two dependency injection libraries, that are Dagger2 and Hilt, in this course. So without wasting any more time, let's start. So we are talking about injecting dependencies. Hence, the first thing that you must know is, what is dependency? Take a look of this simple code. We have a class car that constructs an object engine. Now in this case, engine is a dependency for car. That means engine is needed to construct car. In this code, we are not using any dependency injection concept. As you can see, the class car itself is constructing the engine. The code is okay, it works, and we don't see any problem here, right? But there are many problems with this approach. So let's understand what are the problems that we have with this approach. The first problem is car and engine are tightly coupled. As car is constructing its own engine, we cannot easily use different implementation of engine for car. For example, we have to create two cars. One is for gas engine and another one is for electric engine. Then reusing the same car here is not easy in the given code. Because car is constructing its own engine, passing a test double for car to test different use cases is also not possible. For testing, many times we mock objects that are called test doubles. So I hope you understood what are the issues with this approach. Now let's move to a very simple solution. Instead of car to construct its own engine, this time we are passing the engine as a constructor parameter. Now this approach will solve all the problems that we discussed. Now car and engine are not tightly coupled, as we are getting the engine from outside the car. We can easily pass different engine implementations to car while constructing a car. Passing test double is also easy now for testing. A simple change solved almost all the issues that we had. And this approach is called dependency injection. The engine is a dependency to car, and now we are injecting the dependency via constructor. So it is also called constructor injection. There are two main types of dependency injection. First one that we already seen is called constructor injection. Another solution is called field injection. As you can see here, in both approaches, car is not constructing its own engine, but the engine is being injected into the car. In both examples, we are constructing the engine manually, and hence it is called manual dependency injection. It is an okay solution, but it also has some issues. Right now, we just seen a simple example, but think about bigger projects. For example, engine may also require a lot of other dependencies. So handling all dependencies manually may end up to a lot of boilerplate code that will be hard to maintain. And if you are creating dependencies manually, then you also need to manage the life cycle of dependencies in memory. That can be a tedious task. To tackle these problems, we have automated dependency injection solutions that can be categorized in two types. The first one is reflection-based solution that generates the dependency in runtime. and static solution that generates the code to provide dependency and compile time. In this course, we will learn about Dagger and Hilt. Both are static solution of dependency injection, as both libraries generates dependency injection code at compile time. In fact, Hilt is the recent library that is built over the top of Dagger and now is the recommended solution by Android Jetpack. And Dagger 2 is also maintained by Google and it is also the recommended DI for Android projects. So dependency injection enhances code reusability and decouples dependencies. After dependency injection, the dependencies are not hidden as implementation details. So it is easy to refactor the dependencies now. And after using dependency injection, testing also becomes easier. So these are some reasons to use dependency injection in your project. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. From the next video, we will start implementing dependency injection in our Android project. Meanwhile, please do subscribe to my channel if you're not already a subscriber. And if you want to get in touch with me, then you can follow me at Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. You can also message me there for any question, and you can also comment here in this video. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.